Today we are going to study about Merchant Circle Diagram, which gives a relationship between various forces acting on a chip during an orthogonal metal cutting. Okay, there are many forces acting by workpiece on chip and forces exerted by tool on chip. Okay, and the forces exerted by workpiece on chip are shear force and normal compressive force. Okay. Normal compressive force is perpendicular or normal to the shear force, right? And forces exerted by tool on chip are normal force and frictional force. The resultant forces of Fs and Fn means shear force and normal force is R. And resultant force of force F and normal force is R dash, okay? R and R dash are assumed to be equal in magnitude, opposite in direction and collinear, okay? R can be resolved into Fc and F of t by force dynamometer. Fc means cutting force and Ft means tangential force. This is a diagram which can be resolved easily from the complicated diagram which is given. Fc is the cutting force, perpendicular to it is tangential force, and this is the resultant force. F is the frictional force and normal force, and this is the R dash, which is the resultant of F and N. Then this is the shear force, F of S, and F of N is the normal compressive force. The angles are written according to the provided in the diagram. Using this diagram, we have to find F of S, F of N, F and mu, coefficient of friction, okay, and at last resultant. First, finding shear force, okay. These are the two steps for finding the shear force, okay. Extend line from point O and P to meet at H. Now from point P, draw perpendicular to OC line, okay. From this assumptions, we can say P is equal to OH, okay. So now shear force, FFS is equal to AH minus AO, right. So we can write AH is equal to PE, okay. We need to find AH and PE. So for finding AH, consider triangle PHA from the main Merchant Circle diagram, okay. So this is the diagram which can be extracted from the Merchant Circle diagram, okay. Simplest form we can draw. So cos phi is equal to AH upon F of C, okay. AH is equal to F of C cos phi, okay. Next comes for finding PE, consider triangle PEC. This is a triangle drawn from the Merchant Circle diagram. Sin phi is equal to PE upon F of T. PE is equal to F of T sin phi, okay. So we know F of S is equal to AH minus PE, okay. So we can write, substituting the value of AH and PE, we get F of S is equal to FC cos phi minus F of T sin phi. Second steps comes to find F of N, okay, compressive normal force, okay. We know F of N is equal to CO from diagram, so we can write C is equal to EO. As we know that P is equal to OH, okay, we can say E is equal to PH from the Merchant Circle diagram, okay. So F of N is equal to CE plus PH. Now we need to find CE and PH, okay. For finding CE, consider triangle PEC. This is a diagram which can be drawn, okay. So according to trigonometry, cos phi is equal to CE upon F of T. C is equal to F of T cos phi, okay. And for finding PH, consider triangle PHA, okay. This is the diagram. On the basis of that, we can say sin phi is equal to P upon F of C. So PH is equal to F of C sin phi, okay. So we can get, on substituting the value of C and PH, we get f of n is equal f of t cos phi plus f of c sin phi. Next point comes to finding frictional force F. So F is equal to AB. For finding the value of F, we need to draw some lines which is to be drawn from point P to which is perpendicular to AB line, okay? And from point C, draw perpendicular line to PQ, okay? Which we have drawn before. Means from point P we have drawn perpendicular to AB, which is point Q, okay? From point C, draw that perpendicular line to PQ, okay? I'll show a diagram after this, okay? So F is equal to AQ plus QB. So from figure we can say F is equal to AQ plus DC. We need to find AQ and DC. So for finding AQ, consider a triangle AQP. Okay, this is the triangle. So according to the trigonometry, we can say cos 90 minus alpha is equal to AQ by FC. So AQ is equal to FC cos 90 minus alpha. So we can write this as AQ is equal to FC sin alpha. Okay. For finding DC, consider triangle PDC. Okay, this is the diagram drawn from the Merchant Circle diagram. Okay, so cos alpha is equal to DC upon f of t. Okay, DC is equal to f of t cos alpha. So we can write f is equal to fc sin alpha plus ft cos alpha. Okay, now next point comes to finding normal force. We know normal is equal to BC. Okay, so from the figure we can say BC is equal to QD. Okay, QD is equal to PQ minus PD. So first point, for finding PQ, consider triangle PQA. Okay, PQA. Okay, this is a required triangle. Okay, so sin 90 minus alpha is equal to PQ upon FC. So PQ is equal to FC cos alpha. Okay, for finding consider a triangle PDC. Okay, this is a triangle PDNC. This is alpha and f of t. Okay, sin alpha is equal to PD upon f of t. So PD is equal to FT upon sin alpha. Okay, so N is equal to FC cos alpha minus f of t sin alpha. Now next point comes to find the coefficient of friction. Mu is equal to F upon N. Okay, by substituting value of F and N, we get mu is equal to FC sin alpha plus f of t cos alpha, okay, upon fc cos alpha minus f of t sin alpha. On solving, we get mu is equal to fc tan alpha plus f of t upon fc minus ft tan alpha. Next point is finding the resultant r. Okay, this is a required triangle drawn from the Merchant Circle diagram PANC. Okay, fc f of t, and this is the angle beta minus alpha. So from the figure we can say cos beta minus alpha is equal to FC upon AC. Okay, so FC is equal to AC cos beta minus alpha, where AC is the R, resultant R. Okay, this is a resultant R. Okay, so FC is equal to R cos beta minus alpha. So we can write R is equal to FC upon cos beta minus alpha.